Welcome to Fungi Day Lane. Today we are back to teach you a fun science experiment behind science activities. First law of motion, also known as law of inertia. Okay, guys? Okay. So, guys, what is Sir Isaac Newton's first law of motion? Well, let me tell you. Okay, guys? Okay. Let me tell you in a simple and easy way. But first, there are two types of inertia. Resting inertia and motion. Okay, now let me tell you about Sir Isaac Newton's first law of motion. Okay, guys? And it's very fun, okay? Okay. So, guys, when an object is at rest, it will stay at rest unless it's acted upon a force. Okay, guys? An unbalanced force. And guys, even same for the motion. If there's a tennis ball and it's moving in motion, it will not stop because it will stay in the motion unless an unbalanced force stops it. Okay, guys? Okay. So, guys, now let me give you examples. Okay? So, suppose there's a car and then you hit the brakes. What happens? Well, the force comes and stops the car. Now, Amara, let's have a small quiz, guys.
Experiment time.
No, Amara. Now let's play a quiz. Then we'll do an amazing science experiment. Okay, so guys, the quiz is simple. Amara, which will be easier to push? A shopping cart or a train?
A shopping cart.
Yes. Why, Amara?
Because
let me tell you something. More the inertia, the more the mass. The less the inertia, the less the mass. So guys, the inertia and mass will lessen the shopping cart. So it's the correct answer. But in the train, it has more mass. So that will be harder. And guys, which one of them will be easier to stop and then put them to rest, Tamara?
Yes.
Which one?
Shopping cart.
Yes, again shopping cart because it's lighter. Amazing, Tamara. High five. So guys, now what time is it? Amara?
Experiment time.
Just look at the smile on my sister's face. It's like the whole video. Only experiment, I want no explanation. It's like that. So, Amara, would you like to arrange it? Yeah.
Thank you.
So, guys, the things needed for today
are just 3 cups and a book and a mat.
3 plastic cups, a book and a cloth, Amara. Not a mat. Okay? Guys, what will happen when I put this cloth? When I pull this cloth, it's obvious. Everything will fall. But will it? Will it, Amara? Let's see. And if it doesn't fall down, all thanks to our beloved science, all thanks to our beloved Sir Isaac Newton, it will be proved that the first law of motion will be proved by us if this does not fall. And by our beloved Sir Sir Isaac Newton. I'm sorry about that. So, ready? So, guys, I'm going to show you in 2 ways. Okay, guys?
One like this and
one. No, Amara. So, I will pull it to my stomach, one I will pull it down. Okay, guys? Look, guys, what happened? It did not come because I didn't hear, and plus I didn't put force in it. But now look. Voila! What was that, guys?
It was amazing.
Yes, guys. But how did that happen? Well, let me tell you.
Like super.
Yes, guys, the book and the cup, they were just relaxing. But this, when I put force in the cloth, well, I put force only in the cloth, not on the book and the cup. So that's why only the cloth moved and not the book. This was just steady and it was resting. Okay, guys, like it was very lazy.
Like a statue?
Yeah, like a statue. Okay, guys.
Also like a pillow of nobody touched.
Yeah. Okay, guys, you want to hope you learn the logic behind the science experiment we did today. And if you did, like and subscribe. Bye. Thank you.